In this research methods and psychology video, we're going to cover self-report techniques, including questionnaires and interviews, and the strengths and weaknesses of each. We'll also talk about open and closed questions and what the differences are between structured, unstructured, and semi-structured interviews. I'll finish by telling you how researchers design questionnaires and interviews. PsychBoost.com, over 170 videos to help you with your qualification, and Patreon supporters can access bonus resources, tutorial videos, and the Discord channel. Let's start by defining what a self-report technique is. This means a research technique in which the participant knowingly responds to questions revealing personal information about themselves. This could be a real-time conversation with a researcher directly, usually face-to-face, but it could be over the phone or via text message. This is what we would call an interview. Another option is to have a list of pre-prepared questions that get sent out to the participants. The participants then fill out the questions and then send them back. And this, of course, is a questionnaire. Open and closed questions. Both questionnaires and interviews can use open or closed questions. An open question is one in which the participant is able to answer in any way they want. In a questionnaire, there'll be a space to write the answer. Open questions give what's known as qualitative data. This means data in the form of words. A closed question is when the participant has a limited number of options, for example, just yes or no, a series of fixed choices, or points on a scale known as a Likert scale. This gives a type of data known as quantitative data, data in the form of numbers. When the researcher uses closed questions, because of the quantitative data, they're able to easily compare responses between participants and use data analysis. This is harder with open questions, but open questions give participants the freedom to respond how they want, so may lead to more valid, meaning more truthful, answers. Of course, often questionnaires and interviews will have a combination of both open and closed questions. Designing questionnaires and interviews. When deciding on questions, the researcher needs to make sure they're clear. So, for example, they might try to avoid complex scientific terminology that the participants may not understand. In an interview, the interviewer can reword the question to make it more understandable, but that, of course, is not possible for questionnaires. The researcher also needs to be careful not to use biased questions, otherwise known as leading questions. These questions subtly suggest how the participants should respond, often in a way that will support the researcher's ideas. The researcher might consider piloting a questionnaire interview. What this means is running it with a few participants to check for problems. For example, some of the questions may not make sense and might need to be changed. This is particularly important for questionnaires, as several thousand might be sent out. Filler questions can be used. These are questions that won't be used in the data analysis, but in an interview can put the participant at ease before more difficult questions are asked. In a questionnaire, filler questions can be used to hide the true aims of the study. Structured, unstructured, and semi-structured interviews. So when considering the interview, it's a back and forth series of questions in real time. The questions can be open or closed or a mix, and if it's face-to-face, it's likely to be recorded by the interviewer so they can listen to it again. But the researcher has to decide on a structured, unstructured, or semi-structured style. Let's consider structured interviews first. In this case, the researcher will have a full list of questions that are asked in order. Advantages of this method are you don't need a fully trained interviewer if they're just asking questions from a list. Also, it's easier to compare interviews because all interviewees have had the same experience. However, because the questions are fixed, if the interviewee says something interesting, you can't develop on that point by asking a follow-up question. An unstructured interview is when the interviewer doesn't have a set list of questions that they're going to ask. It's a free-flowing informal conversation with a general topic to discuss. And an advantage of this approach is you're likely to develop rapport with the participants with this more informal style, meaning they feel more comfortable and maybe more likely to give you personal information. Using an unstructured interview means if the interviewee says something interesting, you can develop that point. But with this style of interview, you do need a highly trained interviewer to do it successfully. And as every interview is different, it's going to be really hard to compare multiple interviews. A semi-structured interview is in between an unstructured and structured interview. This is a mix of prepared questions, but with the ability to ask new ones. You still need a highly trained interviewer to think of the right questions to ask at the moment, but now you also have fixed questions that you've asked to every participant. Evaluating self-report techniques. Self-report techniques are a useful method for psychologists. They're easy to replicate using the same set of questions, and the use of open and closed questions give data that can be analysed with statistics and the opportunity for participants to give detailed information about their experience. However, they do suffer from bias, especially social desirability bias, as people want to be seen in the best light, they'll often lie in their responses to look good to the researcher. If we need to compare interviews with questionnaires, we can say questionnaires don't require a trained interviewer and could just be posted online. This means they're very cheap to give to large numbers of people, making them particularly good for data analysis when using closed questions. However, problematic questions can't be dealt with in the moment, and participants might not take them seriously compared to an interview. Quite often, participants will just put yes to every question. Maybe you've done that at some point. It's such a well-known effect, it actually has a name, acquiescence bias. One way of checking for acquiescence bias is by using a similar question later in the questionnaire, but phrasing it in the opposite way. If they tick yes to both, you can see they're not answering the questionnaire honestly. So we can evaluate interviews by flipping the evaluations of questionnaires around. A strength of interviews is the interviewer can rephrase hard-to-understand questions and build rapport with participants so they take the research seriously. But negatives include needing a highly trained interviewer to conduct the interview, resulting in smaller numbers of participants and a higher cost. But an additional problem with interviews is interviewer effects. We're interested in finding out the participants' honest views. We can get very different responses depending on the characteristics of who conducts the interview. Things like gender, ethnicity, and personality of the interviewer can all influence the responses. For example, think about the different responses teenagers might give in interviews about sex, drugs, or opinions on old people, if the interviewer was the same age and gender, or if they were much older and the opposite gender. So that was self-report techniques. I have 6 tutorial videos covering the 2017, 18, and 19 AS and A-level research method sections. These videos have worked examples to every question and are full of exam tips. Patrons at the neuron level and above can access these, as well as many, many more hours of exam tutorial videos, as well as over 100 printable resources from across the A-level over on psychboost.com. And I do want to thank all the students and teachers who have supported PsychBoost over on Patreon during the development of the Research Methods Unit. It's their support that allows me to teach part-time so I can make PsychBoost on YouTube for everyone. So thanks to them, and I'll see you all in the next Research Methods video, Case Studies.